join us for a very solid Saturday evening of rock and roll. Put your hands together and welcome home BMG recording artists, the Jeff Healy Band.
Thank you. said before, hello, welcome, good evening, all that sort of thing. Welcome to this, the first Toronto hometown show during this album tour. I'd like to thank all of you for showing up and showing that you still remember who we are and all that kind of thing. Get you all to welcome everybody here in a good hometown fashion. Right, back on the drum kit we have, you know me, love him, Mr. Tom Stephen. Over on the bass. Joe Rockman. Back on the keyboards. The talented and the oh so lovely with his haircut there, Mr. Washington Savage. How about that? Man, it looks like a savage got to the back of your head. And we've got a couple of vocalists as well doing some great stuff with us. We've got Mishka. Yeah. And we've got Tuku. How about that? Thank you. Leaving me to be, once again, Jeff Healy this evening. Three tunes off of the latest album, Feel This. Thank you. And we'll be doing quite a bit more from Feel This, so look out for that. I've rehearsed long and hard for it. But we'll be doing a few trips back into the memory. Providing our memory holds up, we're going to see just how well it can at this point.
I'm not sure.
feel this out. Because they could all get blown away. Thank you. sentimental romantic thing. It is the latest single from the Feel This album, and it's called Lost in Your Eyes. I was in the time. some years ago, the film called Roadhouse. Some of you were even possibly at the premiere here in Toronto. I don't know. Hands up. Those are the Roadhouse shoes. Thank you. We're going to do a tune out of the flick. It was written by Bob Dylan. They call When the Night Comes Falling from the Sky.
Thank you. Thank you.
something a little different for those of you who have seen the show once or twice. Sounds like an acoustic. Slightly different fashion from what you might remember. But first, a little shot of caffeine. Saturday night, it's not all that hard.
Thank you.
going to hand the honors of the musical intro of this next tune over to Mr. Joe. If Mr. Joe is indeed ready. Are you indeed ready, Mr. Joe?
Thank you.
Yeah.
drums, they're hotter than a pistol, pulling out all the stops and pushing each other to new musical heights. One band member describes the chemistry of Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble as dynamite that frequently explodes. Part of that could come from the music the group plays. It's a blues-based sound with a bit of rock laced in.
The blues are actually, in some ways, a healing kind of music. Because they draw out the bad feelings and make you have a good time.
Lots of bands play the blues, but few are successful as Vaughan. Stevie Ray says perhaps it's just his time. His time right now means more than 2 million albums sold and 3 Grammy nominations. After working his way up playing clubs for 17 years, success is rewarding, but Vaughan doesn't let it get to him. He's still unassuming and laid back. He still feels most at ease when he's on stage communicating with his audience.
Pick out somebody or a group of people or something and play mainly them, and it's like you get this intimacy going on. And of course we're playing to everybody, but you can get a more immediate response like that.
Tomorrow night we'll talk with Vaughan about his future plans and some of the things he still wants to achieve. In Beaumont, Glenn Ely, 12 Eyewitness News.
An NBA score to 449.
Okay, thanks a lot. Stay with us. Concert goers of the Montaigne Center this weekend were treated to a taste of the blues. Guitarist Stevie Ray Vaughan and his band Double Trouble delivered a powerhouse set of their explosive songs. Tonight, reporter Glenn Ely profiles the Austin Axeman in the second of two stories and talks to Vaughan about some of his future goals.
It's been 3 years since Stevie Ray Vaughan and his band Double Trouble exploded like a firecracker onto the music scene. The band's success took many people by surprise, including most record executives who said a group playing the blues couldn't be commercially successful.
When we were talking to the record company, they asked us, they came out and told us that nobody wanted to hear this stuff. And we said, put it out and see what happens. So it was kind of a dare. You know, it worked.
Now that the band's achieved the worldwide following and critical acclaim, Vaughan says he's not going to think about the stardom. Instead, he's going to focus on helping other fellow musicians break into the music industry.
Being able to have a studio would be good. Be able to help some of the musicians that I've heard and will hear in the future. There's many, many musicians out there that I believe have got more to give than anybody I've seen myself, you know, anything I've seen myself do. They should be heard just because they're not as commercial as what someone at a large record label would say, this is it. I would like to see them have the chance.
In Beaumont, Glenn Ely, 12 Eyewitness News.